Mark Hamill talks about how he'd like Luke Skywalker to return in Star Wars Episode 9. His feelings would be if Luke did not return. You know, there's been a lot of footage out with Mark Hamill recently in light of The Last Jedi on home release and digital release. You have the director in The Jedi. You have a GMA interview with Hamill. He has, you know, this story that's kind of making rounds where he's talking about if he comes back in 9 as a Force ghost, he'd like to be a scary Force ghost. He'd like to expand the lore there, because so far what we've gotten is, you know, Force ghosts who stand there and sit on logs, and now they can summon, you know, lightning from the sky. Mm-hmm. But you never see a ghost come back and be terrifying. And I think back to what was said at the end of Last Jedi, and I am intrigued, David, that, you know, if you strike me down in anger or whatever the line is, you know, I will always be with you, Kylo, or I'll always be with you, Ben. It would be kind of cool to see a Force ghost come to a dark side user. I mean, that would be something we haven't seen.
And so when you kind of look at the lore behind this, we know that Qui-Gon started learning this skill, and he can talk, but he can't manifest himself. And really, the only ones that can manifest are Anakin and Yoda and Obi-Wan, and now presumably Luke, too. So, you know, Yoda's not the kind of guy who's just going to go wreck your world and, you know, make you pee your pants in the middle of the night. And I don't think Ben would be either, and I don't think the redeemed Anakin would. But Luke's got a chip on his shoulder. So I could see him coming back and, you know, mentally torturing.
I would want to say it's not possible, but the fact is that Luke was at peace when he became one with the Force at the end of The Last Jedi. So I don't really see him coming back with potentially a chip on his shoulder. I do think it would be cool if, like, yeah, he did appear to, you know, to Ben or Kylo Ren and, you know, just kind of give him some crap, kind of like how Yoda kind of showed up and, you know, gave Luke some, like, you know, a little bit of crap and everything. But
I would love for it to be an opportunity to get more flashbacks. Mm-hmm. Like, what if it was a thing where Luke is able to tap into Kylo in his sleep, and now the dream world is able to be affected, and you're able to see more. You know, Ben, let me take you back to the past. Remember this moment. Remember when I failed you, or remember when you failed yourself. Mm-hmm. That would be pretty interesting. I think that would be another expansion of the understanding of our Force.
Things that we know is that Rey took the books, those page turners. So things to expect to see in the next movie is, you know, that Rey is going to be kind of really kind of harnessing in her abilities. Obviously, she's going to have to rebuild a lightsaber at some point. Maybe this is when we're going to get that staff lightsaber that we were all wanting.
Double-ended lightsaber. So, my question is, what color would it be?
Well, I'm assuming since she still has the crystal for, you know, and everything, it would be blue. That would be my theory on that.
Blue.
But,
blue. Yep. Okay. All right. I want it to be blue too, but there are some people calling for yellow, and I just don't think it would make
sense. She looks good with blue.
She looks good with blue. Always down for some new saber, some saber colors. I do want to read a couple of quotes here that we got from Luke. Saying, quote, "I mean, let's use the word ghost. That implies that it's frightening. But all things considered, especially when I thought that we would never come back at all, you know, I have nothing to complain about." So he's talking about again. If they asked him to come back, yes, he would come back, but he thinks that his story is done. And he's clearly annoyed in the documentary, in the sound. Like, he is still, you know, "I thought I would have a beginning, middle, and end in this trilogy, and I just have a beginning and an end." So I like salty Mark Hamill. It's kind of fun. So whether or not I'm in it or not in it at all, I'm fine with 9. So it'll be interesting to see what happens with Mark Hamill. If you want to see Mark Hamill back in Episode 9, whether that's alive, maybe somehow J.J. is able to keep him alive, or maybe he's just one with the Force and he's if he's a Force ghost, I want to see him behind Rey while she's using the Force to assemble the lightsaber. I feel like that would be a really powerful moment in Star Wars lore.
Well, I like to think that she's going to have like a really, like, for some reason in my head, I picture like she's having this struggle or this emotional doubt moment, and that's where I feel like he's going to pop up. Mm-hmm. Kind of like how, like, you know, Luke was struggling in Empire and then Obi-Wan showed up, you know, on him, kind of thing. Like,
I can roll with that.
You know, that's what I would like to see. I would love to see Mark Hamill return at the very minimal as a Force ghost in the next movie, just to offer some guidance or some hope.
If you haven't already, go ahead and smash that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. You can watch other videos just like this one right now by checking out these videos on your screen. And by the way, thanks for checking out Beyond the Blast Doors.